here comes our message. Let's welcome our host today, Fang Rui Huang.
Okay, good morning everyone, and have you, all of you got this panel? Good morning everyone, and I'm Fang Rui, and today I'm going to divide my speech into two parts. And the first part will be lecture session, and the second part will be have some video. And here is our first session lecture part, and I'm sure you all have the handout in your hands. And when it comes to individual evaluation, and I will think of the semester after next semester. I was EVP deputy, and I was the one who is responsible for the arrangement of the agenda. Yeah. And so I need to find people to take the position, and often was the case that there is no volunteer for the individual evaluator. So at that time, I thought I was just like a lion, and I was walking in a forest, and everyone just accepted me. No one wants to be individual evaluator. So this thing, it looks like individual evaluation is very scary. So I would like to ask all of you, are you afraid of individual evaluation?
Yes.
Okay, that's okay. So here today, here today we gather here together to conquer the fear of individual evaluation together. Yeah. Okay, so if we want to conquer the individual evaluation, so the first thing we need to know is, what is individual evaluation? Someone will have the abbreviation for individual evaluation is IE. And IE is actually a mini speech, a mini impromptu speech. And the time requirement is at least 2 minutes and at most 3 minutes. And if you have many ideas to share with with the audience, then you have 30 seconds leeway. So at most, you can speak 3 minutes and 30 seconds on the stage for your IE. And besides the time requirement, we have to pay attention to individual evaluation is a speech. And what is a speech? A qualified speech must contain opening, body, and conclusion. And just like our warm-up session, it can be viewed as something like compliment, criticism, and compliment. And it is all about three parts. And it can help you to design your IE manuscript. And let's move to next. So we have known what is IE, and now we need to ask how to deliver our IE, how to deliver our individual evaluation. And first we need to know there are some rules when it comes to preparing your individual evaluation. There can be about 3 principles and 2 styles. And let's talk about the 3 principles. And when you are preparing your individual evaluation manuscript, the first thing you need to do is, of course, taking notes. Yeah, because your topic speaker is speaking on the stage, and you are on your seat, and you need to take notes so you will give you a reminder of what the speaker has said and what the speaker has done, or what the speaker has done the best thing, the most impressive thing to involve the strong and enthusiastic response from the audience. And when it comes to taking notes, and there is a special way, systematic way to taking notes. And we will say, wait a minute. When it comes to taking notes, we have done, this is one of the way to taking notes, because actually often in the case we have Apple paper, and here is a blank Apple paper, and we have to take the notes on this paper, and you can divide the space into three parts, and you can draw a T on the paper. And you can write the contents of the speaker in this space, and corresponding to the content on this part, you can write your maybe your ideas or your critics here. So here is the content of the speaker, and here is your ideas about the content. And for the last part of on this paper, you can write make the summary of your ideas from here and here. This is a space for you to design your structure of your IE. And this is one of the ways. And also I have seen others will do it just in a normal way. And in a normal way, it's just we have another Apple paper, and we just to make a list. Maybe just like I like your eye contact, or I wish next time. And you can do something. Another point. You can try both the way to take your note. And for everyone, for anyone, they will have their own style, their own favorite way to take a note. And you can try both the way. And also, when it comes to the next part, is about still notes. Yeah. When it comes to taking notes, if take this way for example, maybe you are a people full of ideas, and you will find, wow, I need maybe 10 points. Wow. I have 10 points to share. I want to share the 10 points with the audience, but this is quite a challenging job because we have only 2 to 3 minutes. So it is very making impossible to deliver your 10 points in such a short time. So when it comes to taking notes, the first step is to take your notes, and the second step is to focus your attention. Maybe we can just choose three points from the 10 points, and we can elaborate each point maybe with about 30 seconds. If you are not familiar with the way to deliver speech with the structure, with the guideline, maybe you can use small points, because maybe you can uh, maybe And this time you can only to say about 20 seconds for each point. Then you can choose more points. It depends on your ability and your style and your style. Okay, so the second part of the second principle is about your ideas. Yeah. And in warm-up session, we have learned the most important thing in individual evaluation is about to compliment and criticism and compliment. And there is a name designed for this structure. And sometimes maybe you will hear, and in IE we can do sandwich. To sandwich way to organize your IE content. And this is just about we have three parts. Yeah. Oh no, sandwich are like this. Sandwich like this, maybe a piece of toast, a piece of toast. And here is your attractive material. Something like your creative. And just like your idea. So you can see here we need to have opening and body and the most important thing is because some of the ideas, maybe some people will perceive your idea as a negative, will involve negative energy. So we need to do some compliments and make some little criticism. And critical, in special, the most important criticism. And it is best to make the content of criticism into minimum, not maximum. You need to maximize your compliments and to minimize your criticism. It will be the most efficient way to convey your ideas to the speaker. Otherwise, the speaker will just reject your individual evaluation because they feel hurt, so they just don't repeat it. For the 3-point focus, just as like I have mentioned, because we have only the limited time, so we need to focus all our attention and all our energy to limited points to try to think of the most efficient way, the most attractive way, the most funny way or normal way, regular way to deliver your ideas to the speaker. So focus. So all in all, the three principles is about first take your notes and then choose your ideas and then make sure you have focus. You have focused your ideas. And when it comes to convey your ideas to the speaker, your public speaker, there is always can be divided into two styles. Just like you have seen in the hangout, the two styles is about one is the safe and authentic way, and the other way is about creative and fancy way. And at the beginning phase of learning how to individual evaluation, I suggest you try to start from the safe way. And what is safe way? Safe way is just like according to this structure, same way is just we have some copy sentence. In the opening part, we can just say, at the beginning, we can just say, he and me, a toastmaster of the evening, and dear fellow members and most unwell guests, I'm pleased to be a individual evaluator, and now move to your body part. And the body part maybe can just start like directly. And I like your eye contact, I like your visual aids because they are very wonderful, they show you have well prepared and something like that. And after you have finished your body part, that is the energy of your tiny feet, then you can move to your conclusion. And the conclusion is the last part of your individual evaluation. So it is best. So I actually the conclusion part, I think it is although it is small, it is not a major part of your speech, but it is also important because this is your last chance to make sure your ideas, your message have go to the speaker successfully. But at the beginning phase, maybe the most safe way is just to say, to start like this, all in all, to sum up in general, and I like your speech and I am very looking forward to your speech next time. And yeah, in Toastmaster Club, we all know this is a cliche. This is old-fashioned ending way. But in my opinion, I think at the first time you deliver your individual evaluation, you can use this sentence because you are a beginner. But once you have become more and more familiar with individual evaluation, I suggest maybe you will want to choose any other more interesting and more efficient way to conclude your speech. But all in all, this is a good start, an easy, user-friendly start to say, all in all, I like your speech and I'm very looking forward to your speech next time. Okay, so how about the fancy way? How about the creative way to deliver your individual evaluation? And I think this is actually the art. When it comes to the fancy way, it is the art of individual evaluation. And the art, yeah, the art is very, very difficult to analyze. But all in all, yeah, you have learned something. Yeah, I like all in all. It is a good changing word. When it comes to creative way to individual evaluation, it refers to your personal style. What is the many way? That means you have your own style, unique properties related corresponding to your individual evaluation. Because maybe some people is so good at critical thinking, just like Amy Chan and George Liu, the judges of yesterday's junior part. They can give a clear, logical analysis of the speech. So maybe their individual immersion is so critical that can help us to learn some lessons and keep us pondering after their individual immersion. But maybe some people are just funny. They are good at to make audience laugh, so they can add this element to their individual evaluation. And maybe some people is good at the description thing vividly, just like Apple Yen. She is good at telling story with touching words, to use some words elegant and something in a word. Apple Yen can use words just like in GRE level, and I can understand her word, but I know the word is beautiful, crystallized, and she has done some job on preparing her individual evaluation. And all in all, so when all in all again, when it comes to fancy way, creative way to about of individual evaluation, the first job we need to do is to know ourselves. Well, to know ourselves, to know what is your strength, what you are good at, and what you are not good at, and try to avoid use what you are not good at, and try to use more frankly what you are good at. But how to find what you are good at? No, there is no shortcut. The only way, the solid way to find your strength is by practicing. Not only by delivering individual evaluation, but also by delivering your speech according to C.E. Manual, Competent Communication. In competent communication menu, we have 10 goals. The first goal is icebreaker. The goal of icebreaker is just to encourage you to stand on the podium and to make yourself familiar with the podium. And once at the C1 project goal, and you have stand on the stage and you are familiar with the stage, and then move to the next goal. Maybe then focus on the organization, on how you deliver your speech. And maybe then next we have some other goals, just like focus on your body language and focus on your vocal variety. And maybe, and I just like PS, the goal is to try to use visual aids, maybe something like slides or the blackboard. So the DE menu matters not only for prepared speech but also for individual evaluation, because all in all, individual evaluation is a kind of speech. And when it comes to speech, they are all the same. You need to have opening, you need to have body, and you need to have the conclusion. And the different things between every speaker is how do they deliver their speech. Maybe by their scale, by their skills, by their content, and by their confidence or something like that. Or maybe by their personal style. I don't know. So about the two style. Okay. So we can move to the next part, the target sentence part. Yeah. Because for a beginner, it is always good to have some material to as a hangout, as a note, to have some example to do things. So here I summarize some target sentence for you to have a reference. And as you can see on the hangout, at the opening part of your individual evaluation, you can say just like, I'm pleased, I'm honored to be Alice individual evaluator. And if this is for the safe way. And for the fancy way, you can try to quote some sentence from the speech or ask the same question or to imitate something in the speech. Yeah. For example, at the junior club, let's say, yeah. And actually, at that time, I'm pleased to be Joey Lin's individual evaluator. Actually, at that time, I was wondering that whether I can imitate something in Joey Lin's speech, because Joey Lin is good at her body language and vocal variety. And at the beginning of her speech, she gave us a little drama of 30 years or 30 days. And it is full of dramatic effects. And if, as an individual evaluator, if I have the ability to repeat the drama, I think it is quite effective to remind the audience of how wonderful Joey Lin's speech is. But this requires practice and some personal style, and I failed to do so. So I just start from the same way. I just said I'm pleased to be joining your video event. But, so it is okay. So you can choose any. I think the point is not whether it is safe or it is creative. The point is, the first thing you need to do is to make yourself comfortable, whether you are comfortable in the stage or whether you are comfortable with your content. You have to convince yourself, ooh, I am a qualified individual editor. I am qualified and I can do something. Yeah, I really say something. Even maybe externally you didn't do so. But first thing, you have to convince yourself. You have to convince yourself, and later you can convince the audience, the other one. And for the body part, here is six elements that you can analyze in the body part. And it is about the opening of the topic, target speaker, and the content and the organization and vocal variety and body language and visual aid. And at this part, I would like to invite one of you to read the sentence in turn because it would be more fun. So about the opening, any volunteer want to read the sentence? No? Okay, maybe I will invite about Verena.
Okay.
Would you mind?
I am pleased, honored to be...
No, about the analysis of opening talk.
The speaker chose to have a different way to open space for a speech by asking questions, telling a story, showing a example. The opening was dramatic, creative, unique, shocking, surprising, etc. The speaker then presented before he or she really started.
Okay, good. Thank you. So, in this we can find the first thing we need to do is taking notes so we can understand what the speaker has done at their opening part. And also when doing our job as individual evaluator and maybe to have some vocal variety is also important. Yeah, so maybe next time you can try to, because you just like this phrase, and maybe maybe you are just not prepared because that is not mentioned. So any more vocal variety will be more attractive and more efficient. So here is for the opening part of the topic speaker. So about the content, and next time I will be the volunteer. Okay. So about the content, we can say maybe. The content is educational, knowledgeable, informative, inspiring, and so on. And the ideas the speaker raised is feasible. Give me this. Okay. And in my opinion, the topic is very unique. Let's draw the audience attention right away. The speaker has provided us with facts, figures, statistics, numbers, and so on. Okay. So, when it comes to the analysis of content, so the first thing is always analysis. And next, you need to choose the proper words, the essential words to describe the content of the topic speaker. But pay attention. When it comes to content, some people think that they don't want to hear about this content because we all have heard the speech. So if you want to do something about the evaluation on the content, maybe we cannot to say too much about it. Maybe at most one sentence or two sentences. And that will be enough. Okay, so move on to the third point, organization. And at this point, any volunteer? Oh no. Okay, how about Miguel? Please. Okay, so in this example, we can find it is quite similar to writing articles. First, we must have a topic sentence, and later we elaborate the topic sentence. Just like the last sentence, has shown. The speech was structured in a logical way. This is the topic sentence, and then elaborate the idea. First, the speaker provided us with something, and then something, and in the end, something. And So when it comes to individual evaluation, to recall what you have learned when you are writing article is also helpful. And about vocal variety, we can say the speaker had a dialogue that made the whole story vivid. Or we can say the speaker imitated adorable sounds of cats and the melodies of violin, unique accent of their mommy, and so on. Or we can say the speaker used poses successfully to create a special atmosphere, and so on, something like that. And when it comes to vocal variety, since you are doing individual on the vocal variety, so the first thing you need to pay attention is, since you are evaluated on vocal variety, so you have to deliver your evaluation in a vocal variety way, and that can be persuasive. So in a target sentence, it is not only the formal sentence matters, but also how the way you deliver, how the way you say the sentence, and the way your body say this sentence matters. And here is just a start point for us to start our individual evaluation. Okay, so how about the body language? Still, any volunteer?
Oh, thank you!
The exaggerated, appropriate, adequate gesture of guaranteeing an appropriate time to add emphasis on da da da. A speaker has firm and constant eye contact here and there. The speaker looks at the audience in the front as well as in the back.
Thank you. Okay, so the same idea. When we are evaluated about body language, so we need to show some body language, and it is the only way to have persuasive effect. So for this example, if actually we are assuming I am really delivering my evaluation on body language, and when I say the speaker had firm eye contact here and there. Yeah, you have to use both your hands and your shoulders position, and also the position your legs, the whole body, to convey ideas, to capture the attention from audience, and also to elaborate your ideas. And for another example, for the last sentence, we can say the speaker looks at the audience and walking in front and in the end. And the main point is, once you are an experienced speaker and you are familiar with the stage and you are familiar with the feeling of your body on the stage, and you can use your hand nature, and then sometimes you can just do the body language and without intention. But that is nature, just practice, and you will one day achieve this level.
I eating, right?
Yeah. Okay, so for the next part, and the analysis of visual aids, and here there's some target sentence, and about the visual aids, it depends, but maybe sometimes we can say, the visual aids helps the speaker to make clear their points. Or we can say the visual aids are interactive and colorful. It depends on what the visual aids your target speaker use. And actually, the one of the interesting things doing individual evaluation is that at the individual time, we can to have some discussion, to have a talk with our target speaker, to confirm the idea, to confirm the ideas we receive is whether correct or not, and to have some chat, to have some understanding of the idea. Good morning. Let's hang out, please. You can have a and sign your name.
Okay, keep on, please.
Okay, so I think in this part, in this talking sentence part, here, what I want to say is, here provide a start point for us to begin your journey on the individual iteration. But don't forget, our spirit, our main purpose of delivering our individual iteration is not so formal. Formal way is just a formal thing. But the most important thing is lies behind this formal thing. Why our target speaker want to choose this title? Why our target speaker deliver their content in this way? These things are quite interesting, and as an individual evaluator, I think we have the duty to understand and to have a chat in a casual way, to just have a chat, and have fun. And that's the most important thing. Okay, so what I have just said is about the fourth part. Why to deliver your individual evaluation? And I would like to say, a little bird told me why. Yeah, bird. So bird is a very medical species. And I would like to summarize my whole point into the four letters. B-R-I-D. A B stands for the brief. Yeah. Because now we can imagine a picture. Here we have a target speaker and we have the audience. And the speaker try to convey their ideas into the audience. And so there must exist some channel between them. A channel. Maybe a round channel, a square channel, a big one, a small one. But the duty of individual evaluator is to make sure the channel works. To make sure the important ideas of the speaker has reached the mind of the audience successfully. So we need to highlight the important things in the speech, or we need to identify what we can learn from the speech. Or we can to summarize the main points of the speech. And maybe at the beginning it will be a hard job, but later and later you will become more familiar with this job and you will do better and better. And for I stands for innovation. Because you can see, we can analyze the individual evaluation in such a structured way. Yeah, because what is individual evaluation? It is just a mini speech. A speech composed of opening body and conclusion. And it is quite boring. And because there are just three elements. And how to make them more fun, more funny? How to add attractive elements into the three elements. So the thing you need is innovation. Yeah. Innovation is just like a spice to flavor your speech. So innovation matters. But what is innovation? What is innovation? Anybody has some idea? Any volunteer?